We continue our conversation with Lisa Pugh and Rachel Watkins Peterson about National Caregiver Month. We go back to the governor's task force, Lisa. Some of the key points that have been focused for caregivers on that from the task force.
So the governor gave that task force a pretty expansive charge. We are supposed to be talking about family supports and respite care and a matching registry so that people can find workers, including respite workers, when they need them. But then also on that paid workforce side, how can we be attracting more people to that paid direct care workforce? Because I think if somebody needs respite care and they can't find a worker, then we keep having the same problem. So we're trying to think about how we can elevate that profession, make sure that those are folks who are paid, that they have paid well, have a career pathway, have access to health benefits. So that those are kind of the big charges of that task force. We just had on November 18th a meeting here in Green Bay, and we'll be having future meetings around the state with the hope to have proposals on the governor's desk with bipartisan support by October of 2020.
In the minute or so that I have left, people are watching out here right now who are caregivers. Just advice for them, help for them. What can you say to them?
Visit Respite Care Association of Wisconsin's webpage. We have a tremendous amount of resources available. We also have a listing of all of our program offerings, as well as a registry that people can access to hopefully find a respite provider that's a good match for them.
So there's no need to be overwhelmed if you are overwhelmed.
Help is on the way.
I would say don't be afraid to ask for help. And if you're someone who's listening to this and you are somebody that takes somebody to a doctor's appointment or you help make sure somebody gets their medications, you are a caregiver. And it's important for you to think about your own needs, because if you aren't healthy, if you aren't getting a break, you are not going to be any help to your loved one.
It's kind of like when you're on an airplane and they tell you put your oxygen mask on first before assisting others. That really is what you need to do.
Ladies, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We leave you this morning with some of the websites for information that you can access if you are a caregiver or you need to know much more about the topic. Until then, have a great day. We'll see you next Sunday morning.